Hi, today we're going to be learning how to use the CloudLibrary app. This is how you access your e-audiobooks and eBooks that you check out using your Cosby library card. I'm using an Android device today, so if you're using a tablet or an Apple device, the interface might look a little bit different, but the basic principles should be the same. I've already downloaded the CloudLibrary app from the Play Store. Make sure that the app that you download shows this logo. And the first time you open CloudLibrary on any device, you'll be required to enter your library card information. So we'll select the country, just the United States. We'll select Texas, way down here. And then we'll select the Cosby Library. Now, occasionally on some devices, it will ask you just to search for your library, and in that case, it is easiest just to put in the word Cosby, and it will take you to the correct library. And we'll need to read our user agreements and accept those. And now we need to put in our library card number and our PIN. Remember, if you've never changed your PIN, it is likely the last four digits of your phone number. I'm going to pause the video so that I can put in my information. So when you log into CloudLibrary, it will automatically take you to this tour page where you can look at a few of the features that CloudLibrary offers. If you want, you can click on skip to skip this page. I'll go through these as I'm giving you a few tips about CloudLibrary. Now, occasionally, when you try to log into CloudLibrary, even if you've double-checked the library card number and you know you're entering the right PIN number, it will still tell you that either you're not allowed to check out books or that the library card number is invalid. If this happens, you might try completely uninstalling CloudLibrary and reinstalling it, and that usually fixes the problem. Another thing to know about CloudLibrary is that you can personalize your library card. So you can see that I've already personalized mine with a little wizard hat since I love fantasy. If you click on the little barcode symbol in the upper right-hand corner of your virtual library card, it will actually flip it around and will show you your library card number. This is really handy if you have misplaced your physical library card or if you're ever stuck at the library and you want to check out physical materials but you can't find your card. You can pull out your phone or your mobile device and you can find your library card number right here in CloudLibrary. You can even use it to use the self-checkout machines. Let's take a look at our library messages. So one thing to know about CloudLibrary is that you want to think of it a little bit like having physical items. You can check out things, you can turn them back in. So here we're trying to remind people that you can check your items back in early. You don't have to wait for them to time out and for CloudLibrary to automatically remove them. You can go ahead and return them yourself. And that will allow somebody else to use that item and you'll be able to check out more items. You are limited to 7 checkouts on CloudLibrary, so 7 items checked out at a time. You're also limited to 7 holds at a time. Now do bear in mind with CloudLibrary that there are occasional outages, just like with any other online service. We do try to post when there are outages on our social media, and CloudLibrary is usually really great about getting things back up and running. I'm going to click on the bottom to search, and we'll start looking for a book or an audiobook. Now again, this interface will look different on different devices. You can actually use CloudLibrary across multiple platforms, so if you prefer to search on, say, your tablet or your desktop, you can check out items on those devices and then come back to your smartphone and start reading those items that you've checked out. We'll find out how to look at our bookshelf here in just 1 minute. But here it shows some collections that we, the librarians, have put together that might be of interest. But if you have in mind what you want already, you can always search. I will actually be doing a separate video on all the different ways that you can search in CloudLibrary because it actually has a lot of flexibility for you to search for exactly what you want or for you to set up some custom browsing opportunities. So CloudLibrary takes a little bit of time to get to know, but it is well worth it. Once you have it all customized and personalized, you will have some great items to choose from. One of the other things to know about CloudLibrary is that we actually share items among multiple libraries. So this is a program called CloudLink. So some of these things we've actually bought and added to our catalog. And bear in mind that when we buy an item, sometimes we are allowed to keep it forever until we decide to remove it. Sometimes we are limited to a certain number of checkouts, and sometimes items will be taken out of our catalog after a year. That all has to do with which publisher we're getting the item from. So if you find something one day and then it disappears another day, either its time with us is up, or maybe it's an item from another library that somebody has checked out. So there is a little bit of mystery involved with CloudLibrary. Sometimes you see something one day and you don't see it the next day. And if you have problems with that, you can always give us a call and ask us, and we can try to figure out why you're not seeing that item that you were looking for. All right, so let's go ahead and see how you can check out a book. So I'm going to click on just this first book up here under Staff Picks. And when I click on that item, it will show me some more information about it. I could actually click on the author's name, and that would take me to more books by this author or more audiobooks by this author. I can borrow it. I can save it for later. I can basically save it to a favorites list. I'll see some more information, a little bit of a synopsis about the book. And then if I decide to check it out, I will just click on this green borrow. So I'm going to do that right now. And now I'm going to go up to the top, to the left of book details, and I'm going to go back. So from here, you can actually go ahead and read the book. You can return it if you made a mistake. You can go ahead and decide to save it for later. I'm going to go back right now because I want to do a few more things before we go and look at our bookshelf or at our account. So I'm going to go to this second book now, The Eric Idle Always Look on the Bright Side of Life. And I'm going to save that one for later, just so we can see what that looks like in our account. Okay, so now I've checked out one thing, I saved another thing. I'm going to go down to the very bottom where you can see four options. You can see home, you can see my books, you can see search, and you can see account. So I'm going to go to my books. And here you can see this item that I've checked out. And the down arrow means that I could download this and I can read it on my device when I don't have an internet signal. So this is really handy if you don't have consistent access to the internet. Just download your books when you do and you can read them offline later. Next time you log into CloudLibrary, it will remove any books that have expired that are due back in. I could also go ahead and return this book if I wanted. I could mark it as a favorite. If you look next to the title to the right, you'll see a little heart. I can mark it as a favorite. Now I'm going to go back up here to the top, just under the My Books. You can see current, you can see history, you can see holds, and you can see saved. I'm going to go to saved. And there you can see that book that I saved. So if I decide that I'm ready to borrow this, I could click on borrow. I could take it out of my list by clicking unsave. I can also see a history of my account, some things that I've played around with in creating this video tutorial. So you can see I've checked out and returned a single thread already. I've checked out a few other things. Let's go back to my current books. And now I'm going to go back down to the bottom. I'm going to click on search again. And now I'm going to try to find something that I know has holds on it. So maybe some of these coming soon items. Let's see. Oh, I know that the Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes is going to have some holds on it. That's a new Hunger Games prequel, so I know there's going to be some holds on that. I'm going to click on that. All right, so see here, you can click on hold. It's going to tell you when this is going to be published. I can click on hold. I'm going to go ahead and put myself on hold for this item. It's going to ask me if I would like to receive an email notification when it's available. I'll click on yes. Here I can turn on my email notifications, put in my email address. I'm going to go ahead and skip that for now though. Up at the top on the left, I can click on that back arrow to go back. And again, I'm going to go down to the bottom, click on my books, go to holds. And once it updates, you can see that I have that item on hold. If this is something that we actually already have, it will give you an estimate of when you might get the book. So it might say 80 days, it might say 14 days. It estimates based on the number of copies that are available and how long at the maximum someone would have to keep that item. This is why we encourage people to turn in items early if they're done with them, so that way everybody can get their holds a little bit sooner. Let's look really quickly at some of our options under the account button. So all the way down at the bottom, all the way over to the right, let's click on account. Here I can view my cards, I can view my library details. This is actually where that notifications option is, that notifications option. I can turn on email notifications. Cellular data usage, the fourth item on the list here. When I check out audiobooks, I can choose whether or not to use my data while I'm streaming or while I'm downloading. If I turn both of these off and then click on apply up in the upper right, this means that I will need to have Wi-Fi in order to download audiobooks. So that can save me, if I have limited data, that can save me from using up my data on something that I don't want to use it on. I can change my reader ebook settings. I can choose whether or not I want to share anonymous usage data, and I can also get some help and support from CloudLibrary. There's actually some tutorials available from CloudLibrary that can help you use the service a little bit better. And I can find out more about CloudLibrary. And then whenever I want to return to my home page, I'll just go down to the very bottom left, I'll click on that home, and I will be back to my home page, where I can see my card, I can see anything that I've checked out or that I've started reading, and be on my way. So I hope this gives you an idea of how to get started with CloudLibrary. Again, I will be making a second video with some more advanced search techniques and how to customize your CloudLibrary experience. So if you want to know more, please see that video. If you need any extra assistance, please give us a call at 972-304-3655, or you can email library@coppelltx.gov.